Good evening. I'm Grace Randolph, and tonight we're going to see if a reputation can be murdered. You're watching Beyond the Thriller's review of Hitchcock.
Good afternoon.
This book, Psycho, is fiendishly entertaining.
Is this really going to be your next picture?
Charming. Doris Day should do it as a musical.
This is Mr. Hitchcock's next film.
Fine, if you can get the money.
Who do I make it out?
Why are you letting him do something so tasteless?
Don't upset yourself, darling. It's only a bloody movie.
More anger! More!
How does it end?
I promised Mother I wouldn't tell.
For decades, Alfred Hitchcock has been regarded as one of the most famous and unique directors in the history of cinema. Yet this year, two films seek to show the terrible price others paid for his genius. The first was HBO's The Girl, based on Tippi Hedren's scandalous accusations that Hitchcock sexually harassed her, and then, when she rebuffed his advances, ruined her career. But with that project, it was hard to differentiate between the truth and the bitterness of a failed actress whose stories about Hitchcock get more and more salacious the more attention she gets for them. But now comes Hitchcock, which focuses on a defining time in the director's career, where he bet it all on a little film called Psycho, and ended up creating the enormously successful slasher genre. Which is interesting, as for Psycho, he stripped away the trademark glamour of his usual films, fully exposing the exploration of sex and psychosis that had always been present in his work. And in some way, documentary director and first-time filmmaker Sacha Gervasi has done the same here. Gone is the reverence with which Hitchcock is usually regarded, and Hitchcock's own voyeuristic camera is turned on him. Some have found the result to be spellbinding, while others straight up camp, the new Mommy Dearest, if you will. But I loved Mommy Dearest, and while it might have been a very one-sided look at Joan Crawford's personal life, it was true to that one side, her adopted daughter, Christina Crawford. And here in Hitchcock, Gervasi is true to the perspective of Hitchcock's wife and apparent collaborator, Alma. A big deal was made of Catherine Bigelow being the first woman to win the Oscar for Best Director, but it seems that women have been influential in film for quite some time, only in the shadows of their husbands. Fascinatingly, Marshall Lucas was another editor, just like Alma, who single-handedly saved her husband's film in the editing room. Perhaps it is time that these women get their due. After all, isn't one of Hitchcock's most famous themes revenge? Do you believe this movie is true?
I think it is.
Yeah?
As far as I, you know, what I know of Alfred Hitchcock, I mean, I don't know his life story completely.
I've read books on Hitchcock, mm-hmm. and I read the book that this was based on, and the thing about the bit about his wife possibly having an affair or him thinking she was having an affair, I don't remember any of that.
Okay.
Plus, I mean, the his basic hallucinations with Ed Gein
yeah.
and all that sort of thing. I know it was based on Ed Gein, but I think they added a lot of that stuff.
Well, how do you like learning about the personal life of an artist? Would you
I
rather
love
just...
it.
Oh,
no,
you do?
I love learning about that.
Why
yes.
do you like it so much?
Because I think it gives you an insight. I think it gives you an insight where he comes from in his films. And there's so much of his personal background that comes into a film anyway, of any artist. Mm-hmm. I think so. It's really, to me, it makes it exciting.
Well, what do you think of taking that kind of liberty?
I don't know. I was sitting in the movie wondering what his daughter must think of it. Because his
yeah.
daughter is, if you get the DVDs of his films, his daughter is always prominently interviewed. And she was in Psycho, actually.
Mm-hmm. And she's still alive.
Yeah, she's still alive. And I'm wondering what she thought of that film. It actually occurred to me while I was watching the movie. Because we all know that Hitchcock was... He had a lot of problems,
yeah.
obviously.
But that many, right?
I'm not sure if he had that many, but, you know, maybe he did.
Did it change how you felt about him at all as a director?
No. In fact, I think I liked him more.
Oh, really?
Because he was so real, and it was so... He had a difficult career, but I know a lot of artistic people have difficult careers.
I mean, I thought it was an interesting movie.
Yeah?
I mean, after a while, I kind of stopped thinking about Hitchcock and just started thinking about Anthony Hopkins as Hitchcock. I did think Helen Mirren was a little bit too glamorous to play Alma.
Mm-hmm.
I've seen pictures of Alma. And, you know, not to say anything disparaging, but she just doesn't look as good as Helen Mirren.
Just a different character.
Yeah. I've seen Helen Mirren in other films, and she's still a very attractive woman.
Did Anthony Hopkins disappear into the role for you?
I thought so.
Well, it sounds really like you really liked the movie.
I loved it.
Oh, good. Well, you know, it's getting... Some people just say it's like tasteless camp. What do you say to those people who said that about the film?
Well, everyone has their taste.
True.
A chacun son goût, as the French would say, to each his own taste. But yeah. I think, as you say, it's just their opinion. But I just think the majority of people that are my friends and people I know are going to love this film.
Well, why do you I'm think that highly is? Rebecca, why do you because, like it so much?
Because it gives you a whole insight into Alfred Hitchcock and that idea of the way he made the film Psycho. It makes so much sense.
I would recommend it. I mean, but then again, I mean, a lot of people today don't really know Hitchcock. The younger people today don't know Hitchcock. I don't really think they know or they really care
That's
all that much
shame.
About him. So it's only the film buffs who are really going to be into this movie. Like a couple months ago, they showed The Birds here. They had that one of these Fathom Events showing of The Birds right in his theater. And I stayed to see it. And I noticed something very interesting in that. People were laughing during the bird attack sequences. And I was truly shocked. And I wanted to turn to some people laughing and say, you know, I don't think Hitchcock meant this film to be a comedy.
No.
But they were hysterical. They were attacking the school and the kids laying on the ground. People were laughing. And I said, I don't know. I'm not sure if the audience is the same today as they were when Hitchcock
was making
these movies.
Yeah, that's an interesting question. What would you give this film on a 1 to 10?
9.5.
I would give this film an 8.
So if you're a Hitchcock fan and you don't mind your biographies with a grain of salt, you might want to check out Hitchcock in theaters. Otherwise, it sounds like you can wait for the DVD. And be sure to participate and be on the trailers poll of the top 10 movies of 2012. Go to tinyurl.com/bttvote2012 to cast your vote by January 3rd. A link is in the video description. I'm Grace Randolph reporting from Regal Union Square, and I hope you'll go beyond the trailer for these other top movies.